Hello everyone, my name is Corey Martin and I am a composer and producer for Brand X Music, and today we'll be looking at my track Spiritual Leaders off the album Realms. Realms is an album that we put out in 2021. We ended up being able to go to live string orchestra on this album, which was really, really fun, with this orchestra out in Budapest. And so that was great. The string session ended up being at like 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. We just kind of sat here on a Zoom link and were very, very tired, but it was amazing. And we have since gone back for more with that orchestra. So here's the track. So this track, like a lot of trailer music that we write, kind of exists in three sections. There's sort of an intro, a B section, and then the huge, obnoxious third act. So first off, you'll notice that we're listening to the master. This was mixed and mastered by Rob Beaton. I play that. Because his mix and master is just so much better than mine. So let's go ahead and dig into that intro. And so kind of the big thing that the intro is all about are these synth pads, which is mostly just either stuff that I did with analog synths that I have, or lots of, you can see here, I used some Nucleus. I used a little bit of, what is AI again? I think it's Audio Imperia, yeah. Lots of movement in the pads, which is kind of something I'm always looking for. Then at some point, this arpeggio comes in the bottom, which is just a Moog sub 37 that I have in the back of my studio here. And I'm just like obsessed with it. So I just love to send MIDI data back to it and get some cool sounds that, you know, I wouldn't be able to make if I was sitting at the synth and sort of like messing with the knobs and filters at the same time as playing. So it's a lot easier to sort of just send back data and then just kind of sit in there and just try to make it sound good. Kind of goes back and forth between major and minor, which is something I really try to play around with in this track quite a bit. Vocally, something I really love to do with my tracks is just, no matter what, just like throw vocals on it. Most of the time they don't end up sounding like vocals, but it just kind of, when so much of this music is sort of made in the computer and it becomes this mastered 2x4, it's always just great to have some sort of element that brings out a human characteristic in the music. And so most of the time it's like just me sitting here trying to make myself sound like I'm vaguely a singer. My wife is actually an incredible singer, so much better than me, and she does it professionally. And so naturally I drag her in the studio and have her do some stuff, and then take her beautiful voice and make it sound super weird. Yeah, so you can see I did, you know, like I used some manipulator here to make her sound weird. By herself. Oh, that might be me. That's totally me. Look at me go. Yeah, I did have Natalie sing later on at some point, though. Breakdown again before we go to the back end, just, you know, for dramatic trailer effect, just, you know, makes the people go wild. Yeah, so looking at some of the stuff, so there's lots of short strings coming in halfway through that section that are just kind of doubling my same arpeggio that I had going before. I really try not to introduce too much musical data that it, like, nobody knows what the track's about. Somewhere in that section, I start to incorporate a few more key textures. Look at that. I threw some harps in there. Who would have allowed that? Today, harps, get out of here. Who do you think you are, John Williams? But like I said, I have this sort of this choral section, and it looks like it's probably a combination of Natalie and I, but who knows at this point? Like, it probably just sounds so different than the raw audio files. At the end of the day, it's sounds that only you can make. I just really try to encourage people that are trying to find their own sound, like, find the thing that makes you. And for my career, a lot of it has just been like, stick a mic in front of you and see what happens. And a lot of the times the results are terrible, but in this case, it worked out. I must have rewritten this third act so many times because I kept just kind of making it very clearly like major, very clearly minor. And the whole point of this is like you're entering this realm and you don't really know whether it's a good realm or a bad realm. Yeah, that we really, really tried to stay ambiguous, mostly so we could get a bunch of different types of licenses. But we just thought it'd be interesting because so much of our music is very black and white. It's like either it's explosions and scary images and superheroes, or it's, you know, Disney fireworks. Short strings in this section are just sprinklers, basically. Yeah, it's just, you know, some more I guess I used some other libraries here, but lots of OTT on the short string bus just to make them cut through all the nonsense. Let's look at the brass. So obviously huge brass section in this. So let's listen to some of the percussion here. Yeah, just loud drums, not an oboe to be found. I just kept going with the whole vocal choir thing and just made it louder, saturated it more. Going down here to the synths, looks like I've got a few things going on. So just something really bright, and then when it combines with the sub 37 down here. It's like what everybody like in their head thinks underscore. Got some Brahms for all you Brahm heads out there. Big Brahm heads. AVA Instinct again. Some big old pings. Just like huge tail, obviously, on those. Then obviously just so much rise. And that's Spiritual Leaders off of our album Realms. That's that. If you have any more questions, feel free to comment down below. This track is available everywhere. It's on Apple Music, Spotify, YouTube. And of course, if you are a music supervisor, it is available for you right now to license for your next big project. On that note, thank you all for watching. My name is Corey. We did it. We did it together.